Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. Look at this place. Do you know what this is?
No, I don't know.
It's called the Slough. So the Slough is the main artery providing fresh water through the river of grass. Now, you know it is the middle of the dry season, right?
Yeah.
Interesting. So why is there so much water here if this is the dry season? So the Slough is the deepest water habitat in the really shallow Everglades. For sometimes 11 months of the year, there's water out here when everything else is dry. Do you hear that?
The bird calls? The wind?
No, it's something different. Listen really carefully.
I can hear it now.
The Slough is the perfect place to see and feel that heartbeat of the Everglades. I'm talking about the rhythm from the dry season or drought to the wet season or flood. This is an annual cycle between drought and flood, which is the heartbeat of the Everglades. So every year during the wet season, water fills up the Slough habitat, and it goes into the cypress habitat, and then into the prairie. But every year, guess what?
Water levels go down during the dry season.
Excellent. During the dry season, the Slough is the place to be. A lot of wildlife congregates in the Slough where the last drops of water remain. It's kind of like those alligator holes out in the sawgrass prairie. It is a watery refuge for lots and lots of wildlife like fish, invertebrates, turtles, alligators, amphibians, snakes, wading birds like egrets, wood storks, ibis, limpkins, and herons.
Oh my!
There's limited space here. And the competition can be pretty fierce. Not everyone will make it out alive. There's also new life. Some water birds nest in pond apples growing by the Slough. Zinhinga adults start feeding their newly hatched young from the Slough's fish food buffet.
Everyone is packed into the Slough like sardines.
But no worries, around May or June, the wet season rains and storms will arrive. Those survivors and the newly hatched fish and invertebrates will pack up their bags and leave the Slough to repopulate the newly flooded habitats. At the same time, predators like alligators and wading birds will also pack up their bags to follow their mobile prey foods. This seasonal cycle has been part of the Everglades for thousands of years. Wet season, dry season. Wet season, dry season. Wet season, dry season. Wet, dry, wet, dry, wet, dry. Wet season.
Dry season. So, it's the ebb and the flow of the Everglades heartbeat. That's pretty cool.
Go ahead and explore the Slough for yourself. Look around. There's a lot to see at this time of year in the dry season.
Okay, I'll be back in a little bit.
What did you think of the Slough?
It's a beautiful day to be up. The sun felt great. I heard a lot of funny sounds, like croaks from the herons and the egrets. I saw a little green heron perched up on a branch, looking for fish. I saw an anhinga pop its head out of the water as it was diving for food. I saw the baby alligator sitting on the porous limestone rock. And I saw a red-bellied turtle right by an alligator. I can't believe how all these predators and prey live right next to each other.
Nice. The slough has some cool aquatic plants as well. The dominant aquatic plants of the slough are either submerged or floating around like water lily or spatterdock. Plants sprout up from the peat soil that supports a rich food web. There are two sloughs in Everglades National Park. The largest is Shark River Slough that flows into Shark River and then into the Gulf of Mexico. Right now, we are in the much smaller Taylor Slough, and that flows into Florida Bay. But keep in mind, the water in all these sloughs is completely managed by people so that the water no longer flows freely like it used to.
Why is it called Shark River Slough?
Well, don't worry, there are no sharks in the slough because this is fresh water. But this slough will eventually go all the way down to Shark River, which is by the mangrove coastline, where you will find baby sharks. Anyway, I think the mangrove habitat is your next destination. Well, good luck.
Okay, thank you very much. Mm-hmm.